Hi! We were looking for an easy way to demonstrate our new free shape tool, and guess what we've come up with? The annoying orange video. If you've always wanted to recreate this famous effect, or place your face on any other object, today's the day. Let's see how it's done in VSDC. Start a new project and import a picture or a video with the fruit. If it doesn't fit the size of the scene, use the autocrop feature. Perfect! Now let's add a video with your face in it. We'll start with the eyes. To create a mask, select the free shape icon from the toolbar and, yep, now there are four buttons here. Let's quickly take a look around. The free shape button serves for creating a group and drawing a shape from the start point. Insert point means you can add a point to the group. Start new path. This option allows you to start drawing a shape from the start point in the group. Start new shape allows you to cut a shape from start point in the group. And the from gallery option allows you to use a template from the gallery. Alright, now make a click on free shape, select spline path, and just start building the shape you need. In our case, it's a mask for your eyes. For higher precision, you can zoom in on a scene by pressing down the control key and scrolling up the mouse wheel. Now paint the shape black and switch to inverted mask. That's it! You've just created a mask. Now let's smooth its borders using Gaussian blur. In the blur filter parameters, select extend the boundaries to blur levels 25. Go back to the main timeline tab, drag the eye and place it over the orange. Switch the blending mode to multiply. Okay, now find the basic effects menu and tweak the parameters to achieve a better result. Duplicate the eye and place the copy right next to the original. Then duplicate the video with the mask, but delete the mask from it. Select the free shape tool again, and this time create a mask for the mouth. Switch the mask mode from blend to inverted mask. If you feel that the mask shape has come out wrong, you can click on any point and drag it the way you want. When you apply the Gaussian blur filter again to smooth the borders of the mask, you don't need to change the parameters. The value you set previously will be applied by default. Go back to the main timeline tab, drag the mouth to the designated area and switch the blended mode to multiply. Adjust the sizing if you need to. And use the basic effect settings to achieve a better result. Well done! The annoying orange is alive! Go ahead and try it for yourself. Experiment! Have fun! We hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Give it a thumbs up if you did. And remember to subscribe to the channel. The next video is coming next week.